I had to do a completely fresh install of the fucking emulator because it was so fucked up. All right, new game.
After months away, John Marston has returned to his loved ones. While trying to rebuild his ranch and win back the trust of his family, Marston awaits whatever life will throw at him. As he drives home one evening from an errand, he ponders whether a man can ever escape his past. He is a man who is ready for anything. Almost anything.
Yeah, I fixed it. I had to do it. I had to do a completely fresh install of the entire emulator. It's the only thing that works.
Oh, damn.
Mother.
Oh, I'm sorry. I meant to say, damn this awful son I've raised with his highfalutin ways and his shame that his mother swears like a sailor and sews like a blind man. Is that better, your lordship?
Much better, mother dearest.
Oh, good. I'm so glad, my darling. When you finished your university education and are far too good to even acknowledge my existence when we pass on the street, and you gently kick me aside and begging old crow out of the way with your highly polished boot, well, think of me kindly, at least, will you, my son?
I'll try to, Mother. I'll think, that woman I just kicked, that used to be my dear old potty-mouth mom. Maybe I should bother to kick her harder.
Dear boy. Oh, I am so proud of you. Get off. Now, Father's here. Maybe he can beat some sense into you.
Something funny's going on out there.
Hey, John.
Damn dogs gone crazy, and wolves howling, and birds flying.
Well, it's just the storm, John.
Maybe. Uncle make it back yet?
I thought he was with you, off drinking in the fields. I mean working, as you call it now.
He went into town a few hours ago, after we busted that hammer working out in the meadow.
Well, he's probably holed up in some place of ill repute waiting for the passing of the storm.
I hope so.
Zambies.
Well, that old man can take care of himself.
I know. Just a funny feeling I got.
You gone psychic, Paul?
Either that or I ate something funny. Knowing your mother's cooking seems more than likely.
Mm. Well, talking about food, who's ready for some poisoning?
Me, my darling.
Yeah, I'm back.
I am starving.
It was a process. I had to go to the Xenia website.
Just some book about monsters.
Download a fresh copy of the emulator and then move everything over
to
it.
Tell me about it.
It's kind of dumb.
That should suit me just fine.
Well, it's all about, in ancient times, how Aztec warriors worshipped the sun. But during full moons, some of them worshipped the moon instead. And upset the equilibrium of things. So anyway, what it involves is, there's this one guy, and he goes out in search of his family.
You good, John?
That leaves him all alone. So anyways, since there ain't no cure, the brave man has to kill everybody. Which is
absolutely disgusting and completely unbelievable. It's getting late. Guess we're not gonna see Uncle till morning.
Come on then, Abigail. Jack, Get yourself to bed, boy. Try to get some sleep.
Ain't you worried about Uncle?
Sure. But he'll have to wait till morning, just like any other man would in his shoes. Night, son. Don't stay up reading too late.
Full moon. Oh.
You okay, old man? You
don't There's look Uncle.
So good. John!
What is going on? What the hell is wrong with you? Crazy old bastard!
Where are you going?
To get my gun.
Double barrel shotgun. Oh, Uncle's back up.
Uncle! You dumb son of a bitch! Stop!
Time to put him down. Tough.
You brought this on yourself.
Holy shit, you're tough.
I can't believe I had to kill that poor bastard. Well, you okay, darling? You okay?
Oh.
Abigail. Abigail.
I don't feel so great.
Jack! Get out here! Now!
Good Lord, what's happened? Mama?
Careful, boy.
Mama. Mama! Oh, Mama!
Stay right there, the pair of them. Don't make me no widower now.
Arthur? No. Arthur's already dead. Arthur's long gone.
Sorry, darling. It's for your own good.
Come here, boy.
Maybe this will remind you how to behave.
That's some, like, exorcist growls.
Now, I don't know what the hell's gotten into you sick, crazy bastards or what Uncle's done to you, but I'm going to get help. Stay calm. As calm as you can, seeing as both of you seem to have gotten a little excited.
Stay calm. Eat this bread, zombie.
Jack, be kind to your mother. Abigail, teach the boy right from wrong. Both of you, stop biting chunks out of people. Be back as soon as I can.
You're so silly, John.
I best go find me a doctor in town.
Yeah. I gotta fix the left trigger. It always likes to bug out. Dave, thanks for giving the sub to Jen. Appreciate it, dude. The last week of September is like the best week of September. Because the very last week, gifted subs are 25% off. But it's only the last week of September, which is not as nice as they used to be.
Come on.
Go get help for the boy and the wife. I don't have much ammo.
Wonder what happened here.
Zombie apocalypse, John.
Mr. Marston, sir! Marston!
Hey, it's this guy. Professor, the opiate addict.
What are you doing here? I thought you went back to Yale.
Well, I did, but I came back for another round of research. And now all hell is quite literally broken loose.
What is going on?
Well, sir, I'm a man of science, a man of great learning, a thinker, a wise man, and I'll be honest with you, sir, I haven't got a fucking clue.
Well, ain't that dandy?
What should we do?
Well, I suggest we try to find other survivors, band together, and find a cure, or fight to the death trying.
Well, that sounds great and all, but I'm just peachy, but I'm not sure that I'm cut out for such shenanigans. I was thinking more that, finding a horse and riding back to the civilized north at the speed of knots before writing a paper on the events from the comfort of my study. I'm a scientist after all, right? I mean, I can't do much science if I'm some bloodshot dervish's lunch, can I? Much as I would like.
Your sense of duty is very impressive, Professor. I'm gonna search the back street for survivors.
No, perhaps staying with you would be safer. Could you just wait a sec here, would you please? I'm going to wander down that lonely, deserted street and get my bag.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
You should stay with me, Professor. You haven't got a gun.
Oh, no, it's okay. There's no need to worry. Everyone's already dead. I left my stuff with Mr. Nastas.
Yeah, they're dead, but they're not dead.
Dumb as bricks, but a good sort.
Okay. Well, meet me in a couple minutes.
Affirmative. A couple of minutes.
Yeah, see? Look what you did. Now you're dead. Sorry, buddy. All right, this gun needs to Hold on. I gotta... Fuck! I gotta work my controller out. It's not the time for this. Oh my god!
Anyone here? Hello? Anyone here?
In here, mister.
Come out. It's okay. Come out. I don't bite. Bad joke. I mean, come out.
They got my family, mister.
And mine, I fear. I'm sorry.
We were so glad to see my mom. Because she's been dead for 3 years from the smallpox.
Your mama was dead?
I saw her walk up onto the porch. And then boom! She ate my daddy. You weren't a bad man, mister. You weren't. Sure. He liked to drink, but he weren't bad. And sure, he liked the company of women, but he weren't bad, mister, he weren't.
No one deserves to have their blood drunk. I
mean, no.
He knew how to use his fist. And if a woman spoke out her place, he reminded her of it and everything. And when my mama was dying, people said that he was lying with her sister, but that weren't
okay,
true,
okay, well,
weren't.
He deserved it.
But you said your mother was dead.
Her and Mr. Braithwaite. He's been dead a year. And then yesterday, he walked up that street eating dogs. And he loves animals. All the dead folk have come back to life, mister. Only they ain't happy. It's a funny kind of salvation.
All the dead folk?
All the folk buried at the cemetery over by the churchyard.
My God. I'm gonna go have a look. You wanna come?
I already seen my mom.
No, I don't need any.
I don't need to see
baggage.
Any more of my relatives. Here, mister. Take this. If you can burn them, maybe you can put their souls to rest. Hey, mister! You see my Uncle Mordecai? You burn him. Burn him real good, you hear?
I will slit your damn throat! Sorry about that.
Damn.
Yeah.
Burn the coffin. Hold on, is there anything good in here? Don't look like it. Burn coffin. Hey, Lou. We're at the graveyard. Shit, they are aggressive. For the 95 bits.
I knew it.
Oh, there's Mordecai. That's a big boy. Holy shit! Thank you. Alright, I need ammo badly.
For Christ's sakes! What have you got for me, miss? I miss the fresh corpses. God damn it! Any gifts from the other side, mister?
All right. That's another attack.
Let's go. Whoa.
Man, Seth loved the dead.
Over my dead body.
I'm really out of ammo.
Oh!
I hear him.
How do you like that?
Yes. All right, we're safe for now. The town's gonna be overtaken again, though. Happens all the time.
Now, this is a new low.
Bullshit. Ammo cache. There. Got one of the ammo. Must be upstairs. His tail's a black water.
Folks okay?
Just fantastic. I just saw my daughter get eaten by some creature sent straight from hell. Thanks for asking.
I'm kind of sorry I did.
Sorry, mister. Forgive my wife. We've suffered terribly.
What's going on?
Well, it's the government's fault.
Ain't it always?
Well, they let in too many foreigners. Just
shut my God.
Goddamn border, or things like this happen. My daughter was just some satanic demon's lunch because of the goddamn government. And I pay my taxes. Well, usually.
I think we may be moving a little off topic here. I ain't a wise man, but I have done a little traveling. These creatures ain't like any foreigners I've ever seen.
Thanks for the input, cowpoke. Oh, I got flesh-eating monsters feasting on my family, and I'm taking advice about tolerance from a gunslinger. What in the world has my life come to? And my daddy told me I never should have gotten married. This is all your fault, you useless man.
Oh, not now, Taureen. Not this again. Your daddy was a bully and a drunk.
Well, you ain't no kind of man.
Listen. I'm sorry to interrupt your happy reminiscences. Is there anything I can do to help? Have you got any idea of how we can survive?
Well, you could try shooting them creatures, you dumb fool.
Ma'am, it's been a real pleasure. Sir, you're a man of great patience.
See? That fella ain't hiding away like a little girl who's wet herself.
I thought we... should stick together.
Oh, so we're just gonna stay up here till we either starve or have to eat each other?
What do you want me to do? I ain't shot.
That surely you ain't. Oh, you're as useless as a four-car flush. Oh, God, I should have married Bert Sackett when I had the chance.
Not this again. Maybe you should have. Bert's the right kind of fellow to have around when you have to start eating each other. That's for sure.
Humans?
You one of them, mister?
Do I look like one of them?
Well, don't come no closer. We made that mistake before, lost half our number.
I ain't one of them, you fool.
Well, how do I know?
They can't speak.
Well, I ain't taking no chances.
Kill him, he's one of them!
Yeah.
No, I ain't!
You dumbass.
No chances, Silas.
Have it your way, all right? Listen. I ain't coming no closer. Do you know what's going on?
It's the glass eye. The freak with a glass eye, he caused this.
No. It's the snake oil man. These poor folks have been drugged.
I blame the Mexicans. They haven't been struck down.
All right, we heard a lot of stories, mister. Some say it's a moon. Some say it's drugs. Hey, don't come no closer now. Stand back. Apparently it's worse in New Austin. Must be where it came from.
And it looks like I'm headed down to New Austin. Did one of you say snake oil?
It's the glass eye.
I blame the Mexicans.
Connie McTavish, you don't know
blame
nothing.
The Mexicans.
Chloe was an ignorant shrew. I bet your husband's glad he's dead.
Well, at least my husband never took favors from the stargazers, Lucille Billingsgate.
You say you're sorry, you hillbilly white trash!
Yeah, now how are we gonna rebuild America like this? Now see, I thought we had it all decided. We was gonna be kind and gentle and pay homage to our leader. Who happens to be me?
I'm just waiting for one of them to say, we need to make America great again.
Good luck.
I'm waiting for it.
We never had that decided. We decided we would hold elections and that I would be leader.
You can't even read.
Well, I got gravity. I mean, gravy. I mean, folk respect me.
I am the new king, Archibald Andrews. Me. Now pay homage.
Pull it together.
God, there's already more. Oh my God. Ultra undead are extremely fast.
Come on.
Okay. Get the fuck out of here. Fuck? What gun is that? I just want to stick to like the main stuff. All these towns get overrun anyway, eventually. You save a town and then it gets overrun again.
Yeah.
It's just like bases in Metal Gear Solid 5. It was pointless. Zombies. creature. Oh god, it's that horse. I got one of the horses of the apocalypse.
Let's go.
Hey buddy, you wanna
help this
out?
In?
Horse is casually on fire. Yeah, he's chilling. He don't mind. Yeah, caught him on fire. Nice.
Come on.
Almost there? Holy shit.
Come on.
A long ride.
Let's go.
Oh yeah, and I just realized it's not burning me. John, why are you immune to flames?
Come on.
Oh, it's this place where we met Bill.
Easy. Faster.
Hey, somebody's out there. He ain't one of them. Open the gate. Howdy, mister.
Howdy.
You're gonna be okay.
Step right up! Step right up! Don't be shy.
West
now.
Dickens.
Don't be shy. Nature confounds us, but science saves us. That's the truth, sir. That's the truth. West Dickens, patented tonic. The only 100% original, 200% guaranteed cure against the undead stalking this earth. It not only brings health and fitness to the sick and needy, it repels the undead and saves souls. Why, it's
Yo.
A miracle, and it's available now.
Saturation.
Here at the low, low price
Blue
of
Max.
100 solid gold coins.
With the 6 month tier 1 sub. 6 months just now.
You, sir,
sub for the next 6 months. Holy
like
shit.
Try?
Thank you very much, Blue.
Me, sir?
Yes, sir. Would you care to demonstrate the undead defeating possibilities of this patented elixir?
No, sir, I would not. What I would like is for you to stop peddling this nonsense right now.
Thank you, dude. Appreciate
100
it.
Gold
That's
coins.
6 months worth
well,
of subs.
What price would you pay for
Appreciate
survival?
You tell me, Mr. West Dickens. You tell me.
Well, since you put it that way, why don't all you chaps all take one for free now? And if you like it, when you like it, you'll know where to find me. You won't find any undead around me. Take it, enjoy. Thanks a lot, John.
These people have lost their families. They've lost everything.
Well, that's not my fault. I'm just trying to make an honest living here.
No, you're not.
Well, okay. But can I help it if demand is high?
High?
I'm offering the people hope, John. That's a precious commodity. The tonic really works. These poor, awful, undead creatures can't stand it. Come here. Take a look.
They didn't. Oh, that man walked out. They're all confident.
Works like a charm.
Well, it wasn't quite what I expected.
Stuff is like catnip to those bastards.
Well, I need more desert sage and violet snowdrop, and then I know I can cure this foul plague.
Okay, back to doing your dirty work, am I?
Now, don't be like that. Don't you remember the good times? Please? I'm an old man! All right. Here. Take it. Maybe you can use it to attract some of them.
Okay. I'll see what I can do. And thanks. I'm sure this will come in real handy in case I want to meet some new and interesting friends.
Interesting.
Five desert sage and captooth and 5 violet snowdrop. Okay. I need to get out of here. Let's see. For attack. I guess I just go to the use? I don't know. I'm trying to stick to story stuff. Windy ass area.
Yeah.
No. Oh, okay. That worked out. Ooh, that didn't sound good. Whatever was over there was mean. The world record for Undead Nightmare is like sub 1 hour. But the average playthrough is like 7 hours. Giddy up. You're gonna have to die.
Come go.
Damn, too close. Oh shit. Oh, shooting me? Nearest town. Hopefully we have a okay checkpoint. This option will reload your checkpoint and reload you at your nearest bed. No.
Seth, you okay? What's going on?
Oh, hey there, John. Fancy a game of cards?
Not right this minute.
You remember Moses, John?
He's
a darn sight more loyal now than he was before. Come here, boy. Come on. Come here, boy.
What are you doing?
We were boyhood friends, John. Moses is having a tough time right now. Ain't you, pal?
What's going on?
We're playing cards. Relax, sit down.
I mean, with the undead walking the face of the earth, you crazy dumb bastard.
That ain't nothing.
Ain't nothing? I seen husbands eating wives, mothers eating sons. Graves popping open and the undead rising up. It sure as shit is something.
Oh, boo-hoo. Big tough John Marston is scared a little undead creature walking around. Moses wouldn't hurt a fly, would you, darling? Besides, this ain't nothing new.
Folks in Blackwater blaming it on that glass eye you found.
Folks! 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 Damn them folks, John Marston! Damn them! And damn you! Get him! Get him, Moses! Get him!
After all I've done for you, Seth, and I thought loyalty was important to you.
You can't hurt me. Moses, get him! Go!
Yeah.
Get him!
Get me, Moses. Looks like your dog's lost his bite, Seth. Now what the hell's going on?
The dead have risen, and a virulent plague is turning people into flesh-eating crazies. What the hell you think's going on, genius?
But why?
But why? 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 Why not? Why not? Why the hell not?
'Cause it ain't natural.
Who made you Mother Nature and Mother Superior all at the same time? Who made you, John Marston? Same as made me, same as made Moses.
Is there a cure?
These things tend to fade away. Now, if you want to get rid of it, You should go clear the graveyards. Either that, or stop worrying and become one of them. Now, if you excuse us, we got good times to remember. Happy times.
Okay. See you soon then, Seth.
Come on, Moses. It's your deal. Diamonds are trumps. Come on.
Useless ass zombie. Man, I lost my fucking good horse. Hard as shit to control this one. Kinda like does what he wants.
Yeah!
Holy shit. Oh shit, it's those weird things. Alma. All right.
Damn this godforsaken shithole! I'm beginning to lose my patience.
She had nothing on her.
Sorry, sister. Damn you! Time for my pound of flesh. This is revolting. Bullshit.
Come on. Ah, that's a lot of them. Holy shit. That is so many dead people. Before I do this, yeah, give me a second. Oh shit. Oh, I need to bring him over to the flames.
Thank you.
God, not myself.
Time for my pound of flesh. You claw at my back, I'll claw at yours. That about sums up my luck recently. Jack, things I'd do for you.
All right, one more graveyard. This is not gonna be a long stream. I'm probably gonna do this graveyard and then probably fuck off.
Come on.
I at least wanna get something in today.
Thank you.
All right. Slow down. Finally. Turn to Seth. All right, let's go back to Seth.
I knew this was a waste of time.
ain't right!
Let him go. Come on.
I accidentally went into a mission.
Well, try to. Sorry, boys. She didn't give me a whole lot of choice. Hello, John. Welcome to paradise.
Hello, Marshall.
Might have known you'd survive.
What's going on?
Do I look like I commune with the undead?
Well, no.
Well, then how would I know? My job is
to take care of the folk who live here.
Oh, you heard that one.
How's that going?
How's that going? Well, let me put it to you this way. Cattle rustling and bank robbery are at an all-time low. But murder, blood drinking, and psychotic episodes seem to be somewhat prevalent. Either that, or I'm dreaming.
That's what I'm hoping, too.
How was it getting in here?
It was crazy.
Oh, they must be hiding again. They come in and then just disappear. Town's been nearly overrun a couple of times. Now we're low on ammunition, and I'm two men down.
I'll help you clear the place out if you like.
You're a good man, John Marston. But before that, I'm gonna need my deputies back.
What happened to them two clowns you had before? Gone?
Maybe. I sent Jonah off to look for Eli. They've both been gone for several hours now.
Who'd want to eat one of them?
That's a good question.
Where'd you send them?
Out near the general store. Jonah's got one of these new guns. I'm sure he can't run into any trouble. These things, they'd stop an elephant.
Thank you.
No, thank you. I'm sure you got your own troubles.
Well, I guess I got lucky by accidentally running into this building. I'm trying to get back to Seth. That was a live horse.
Let's go.
This is what power brought. You're gonna pay for killing my kid. Come on.
Hey, Panther. No, I'm not saving your fucking town. Yeah. Good lord, this will take 30 hours if I save every town. I just wanna get back to Seth so I can save the game and fuck off. No.
Come on. Yeah. Come on.
Oh my God. Finally, just about there. Yes, finally.
Well, Seth, sorry to interrupt your party.
Hey, John, come join us. We're having a jig. John, have you met Mary Lou? What about Francie?
I did as you asked and cleared out the rest of the graveyards. Doesn't seem to have done much good.
Good? 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 Is dead good? Are you good?
Stop with your nonsense, you annoying fool. What's going on?
The world's turning, John Marston, and the moon with it. Woohoo! Day follows night, and hate follows love.
Okay, you asked for it, Seth. You either stop dancing and start talking, or prepare to join Moses and the rest of these freaks.
Are you constipated, John? You look very angry. You get constipated when you're angry. Yes, you do.
How the fuck did he manage to train a bunch of zombies?
I'm warning you. Don't play with the undead, Seth. Don't chase treasure. Don't waste your time searching for treasure and discover only a glass eye. Glass eye. Well, warn all you want, cowboy. A load off my mind. Why didn't I think about that before? Because you weren't dancing. Hey, John. Well, how are you? Would you like a drink? We got blood mucus surprise. Come on.
Seth, what is going on?
Aztecs. Or Incas. Or it doesn't really matter. It's all the same. Once every 200 years. This land is doomed. That's why we love it. Mexico. Mexico, John. Ah, Mary Lou, may I have the honor?
Oh. You're a sick man.
Where can I? Can I save here? I'm gonna sleep in your house, Seth. Don't let your zombie friends eat me. Okay, I know that was a short fucking stream, but that's just what I had in me. Thanks for that 6 month worth of sub, Blue. Thanks for the bits, Lou. Thanks for the gift of sub, Dave. Follows, yada yada yada. All right, I know short stream, but it is what it is. I'm gonna go fuck off and watch some Twitch. I promise I'll do a full-length stream once the new randomizer update drops. I promise. But until then, it's short ones. All right, y'all. See you next time.